Hello, everyone. Thanks so much for tuning in. I am Cerise Rennie Murphy, the author of Order of the Seers. I want to talk about the book, Order of the Seers, and how that whole process got started. 2 years ago now, I had just finished writing my first short story ever, which was a fan fiction piece called Spirit to Flesh, which was based on the Twilight characters. I'm a huge Twilight Saga fan. And this movie, this Hallmark movie called The Love Letter, which I really love, and it's very sappy and romantic and whatever. So I sort of combined the characters from Twilight and the storyline from The Love Letter to write this fan fiction piece. And it had been an idea that was in my mind for a long time. And I kept telling myself I couldn't do it and I didn't have the time. My son was maybe two at the time. I was working full time. And finally, I guess I just got up, I think it was, January 1st, 2010, and had started thinking about the story and then immediately shutting myself down. And finally, I just said, you know what? After like an hour-long conversation between me and God, I just decided, you know what? I'm just going to start trying to write this story. And had finished. It's a 16 chapter story in about 2 weeks. It was just pure joy writing it. I mean, I'll never forget that feeling as long as I live because it had been something that I'd been thinking about this story for a long time and had just been telling myself, you can't do it, you can't do it, you can't do it. And when I finally turned on that faucet, it just poured out of me and that, oh man, it was so much fun. Anyway, so I finished that and I posted it and got some great reviews and good feedback from people. After that story was finished, it was wonderful, but I didn't again see myself as a writer at all. I thought, oh, that was such a wonderful experience, but I don't have anything. I don't have any new ideas, nothing. So about 2 months after that, I was washing dishes in the kitchen and it was a Sunday, and I saw this man, this black man with blonde hair and clouded white eyes, and walking towards me, and he could see the future. And almost immediately, I knew his name was Marcus. I knew that he was captured for that ability and used and exploited for that ability, and that there was this whole world of seers who were being exploited by this organization that eventually I found out was the Guild. And this whole sort of story just materialized as I was washing the dishes. I was like, really? Okay. I mean, it was wonderful because I suddenly had an idea for a story that was my own, and that's something I never thought I would have. So that's how the story started. That's how it came about. And then I spent the next couple months just researching and thinking and figuring out the plot, and but it just felt like such a gift. It just felt like such a gift from the start because I never thought that I would have an original story idea and to have that given to me and to have the chance to express it and to bring these characters to life was just absolutely awesome. So that's the first part of this journey, and I think I'll stop here, and then the next video will be exactly what the story is about in more detail about how it all came together. But again, thanks for listening. Take care.